As many of you guys know who follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, y'all know that because I wear so many protective styles, once my hair has been up for a while, I usually will wash, deep condition, and I will take a picture of my hair in its afro state. So right about now, I'm in here doing a little mini homemade photo shoot, and I decided to just drop in and show you guys my fro status. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some pictures showing my fro status from I'm gonna say August of last year to now. So yes, this is my hair. I just have it in like a fro hawk thingy. Okay, I'm so loving my growth. At one point, I kind of felt like, what's going on? I mean, I can see a change in the thickness, no doubt. But, you know, it just seemed like it wasn't growing the way that I wanted it to grow. But, you know, at the same time, y'all know I can be a little scissor happy. But the way I feel about it is I would rather have healthy hair than long hair any day. So I try to make sure that if I start seeing damaged ends, I take care of that. I just big chopped my hair at the end of September of 2013. So this is my third time around. But the first two times, I really didn't fully understand my hair, and I really didn't care to understand it. I just knew that I was natural, but I wasn't really taking those steps to actually taking care of my hair. I knew how to take care of natural hair. I just didn't know how to take care of my natural hair. A lot of us naturals, we go wrong when we do the big chop and step into that natural zone, and we assume that everybody's hair is going to be the same. We watch people use products, and then when we go out and buy the products, we realize it don't work the same for us. I know for me, it's been like that, and it's been a struggle. A lot of people ask me, why did you big chop three times? And third time's a charm, right? No, but seriously, the first time I big chopped, basically, I just wanted to see my natural hair. I wasn't coming awareness of my black self or anything like that, but I did want to embrace the hair that God gave me. I remember being a little girl having a head full of hair. And ever since I started relaxing, you know, my hair kind of just went downhill. After I had my son DJ, my hair started growing long and thick. I mean, it had never reached that length in my adult years. Once we moved to another state, they had hard water there. So, I mean, it literally ate my hair up. My hair was just coming out in clumps. I went about 9 months without getting a relaxer. And then I decided to relax my hair. Well, for some reason it didn't really take, and I ended up big chopping that next month. Even though it showed up as if it didn't take, it took, because you could see it all over my hair once I big chopped. I had to cut off way more hair than I thought I did, because once that gel hit it, or once water hit it, you could see the straight spikes. And every day I was chopping more and more and more. I really didn't enjoy my natural journey the first go round because I didn't know what I was doing. You know, I knew so much. I used to research and know, you know, many of you guys who have been following me since the beginning of time, since the beginning of T-Day 6, y'all know that when I first started my Facebook page, I dedicated it mostly to natural hair care. The tips that I gave were very helpful, but I didn't realize that I was only giving tips from a broad natural hair spectrum. It's like, you know, what about those people who suffer from high porosity? What about those people who suffer from low porosity? What about the people in between? Pause break real quick. I know this don't match, but I just feel like it looks so much better. Back to what I was saying. I always complained about not knowing what kind of pattern I had and how my hair was just growing out crazy all over. It was kinky in the back. It was curly on the sides, and it was zigzagged in the front, and I just, it bothered me because it's like, why can't I just have one set of texture? Why I gotta have so many different textures? I always thought maybe it's some kind of heat damage, but then it wasn't until that third big chop that I realized this is how my hair grows out of the scalp. my hair just grows out in a straighter pattern toward the front. And once I realized that there was nothing crazy going on with my hair, I learned to appreciate my hair. I learned to embrace the different curl patterns. It also caused me to want to dig a little deeper and find out about my hair. One thing about my hair is my hair has always been very dry. Like it when I put oil on it, it lasts for days. For days. But I couldn't understand why my hair was so dry. I don't care how much oil, how much moisturizing lotions or whatever I put on it, my hair was always dry. So after digging a little deeper, I decided to figure out what my hair porosity was. And when I tell y'all, it was like the answer to all of my prayers. If you're natural and your hair is like, it seems like the product just sits on top of your strands, maybe, just maybe, you may need to check your porosity level. I have low porosity. So what I did was I made sure that my hair was freshly washed, and then I took a few strands of it and sat it in a glass of water. Y'all, I let it sit for like maybe 10 minutes. And when I tell you them strands sat up on the top of that water, I ended up leaving it there just to see. I come back, I look in it the next day, them strands was still high and mighty. I'm telling you, if I had a choice between floating on a boat or them strands, I would have definitely went for them strands. They didn't move. So what I did was I dug a little deeper to learn how to take care of high porosity hair. Moisture, heat, and moisture. So this is what I'm using as of now. I use the Carefree Instant Moisturizer Spray. I really love the gold one also. But most definitely, Carefree Instant Moisturizer Spray, or you can use the X-Curl Instant Moisturizer Spray. And what I would do is, I would spray my hair with this spray all over, and then I would take a wide tooth comb or a brush to detangle my hair and just make sure that that moisture is going throughout each strand. And then after that, I take my castor oil. And this is just regular castor oil from the drugstore, Walmart drug department. I think I paid like $1.29 for this, somewhere up in there. And I just used regular castor oil to seal in that moisture. I don't know, for me, I just learned early on. You know, like I said, I've been through this 3 times. And I just learned early on to just try to keep things as simple as I possibly can. Or if I find products I like, I usually try to stick to them. As far as trimming my ends, I think the last time I trimmed my ends was in February. And I trimmed them before that, the month before. I did see a little bit of damage going on around December. So, you know, I just, hey, why not just go and knock them dead ends off before it turns into something crazy? So that's what I do. Do not be afraid to clip off that damaged hair. I know for me, I was one who held on to my ends for dear life because I'm like, I need them few inches. I was never in for it, but I'm realizing now that you gotta get rid of that hair. If you want to have thick, full, healthy growing hair, you have to get rid of any damage that you see. If you don't want to tackle it all at once, you can do like I did for the month of December and February. Just do your trims a little closer. So as of now, this is my regimen. If anything changes, I will be sure to come on here and share with you guys what I do.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope that this video was helpful for you. If you have any questions on my natural hair, please feel free to comment below and I will try to answer any question you may have. Also, if you haven't yet, please check out my blog channel. I will put the link down below in the description box. Thank you, and you guys have a blessed day.